what's up guys, in this video I'm gonna show you the games which brought me 20 wins with 2.9 exposed psyche. We got 20 wins live on stream. Thank you so much for all the support. If you guys don't want to miss any of this in the future, do write down in the comment section first what you guys want to see, like which decks you guys want to see live later and grand challenges, because right now 20 win challenge is over, so I need some content guys, like some content ideas down below in the comment section. I appreciate any support of that. If you guys don't want to miss any of this in the future on the channel, daily uploads every day at 23 or like 11 p.m. CET. Appreciate all the support. Don't forget to subscribe and don't forget to put code MOD in the shop. Appreciate it a lot. Supports the channel a lot. Supports me a lot. This allows me to spend like a lot of time on my videos or like more time in general. And this allows me to do daily uploads even on my English channel. On my German channel, I do daily uploads anyway. So thank you so much for everyone who's using my code. Just buy in-game purchases. You can even use the code in Brawl Stars, Clash of Clans as well. Thank you so guys for doing that. I'm going to see you in the first game of 2.9 Expo Cycle. Let's go. Guys, here in the first game, I think we were like 15-2 at this point. So really tough situation. The first game I lost because I did some stupid mistakes. I failed the Tesla against a Golem Lightning matchup. He did Golem first play. I had no Expo in Cycle. It went to 1-1. He didn't play really well. And then we lost the game at 1-1, even we still had a chance to win, but I misplaced my Tesla, so the Golem went to the tower. In the second game, I played against Balloon Psyche, a tougher matchup for sure. But yeah, I kinda messed up the Tesla once again. Balloon didn't get kite and we lost the game. So 15-2 right now. And he's gonna go for Bowling Back. I just played a defensive expo here, and he plays the Flare deck, or like Flare deck. I don't really know how to pronounce his name in English. But I think you guys know him, he's like the best. Or used to be at least the best grave, like bowler, splash yard, balloon, freeze player in the world. He has like a lot of top 20 finishes with it. So in this matchup, I kind of try to play defensively. Here I'm going to go for offensive expo. Why do I go for offensive expo? Because still a Tesla on the field. I could have just went for defensive expo, but he's just going to go with bowler. Both things I'm going to shoot on him, so it's completely fine. He overspent it a lot. So good situation for us. I kind of tested out, like, or kind of wanted to find out what deck is he's playing. And so I give you like my, well, like not my secret, but like a tip in general. If you play Expo 2.9 cycle, is play defensively, play passively. Don't overcommit with Expo. Don't play like really aggressive archers. Play slowly and control the game. So he's gonna go with him. And Fandering, I'm just gonna go for Tesla. Even he would go to the safe spot on the right hand side of the balloon. Normally, the balloon would go to my tower, but I still could fireball the balloon into the Tesla. And so he doesn't have any big spells, so he has to play into my Tesla. We're gonna go with Archers in the back. And he's just gonna go with a baby dragon in the back. I'm gonna lock here. Gonna go for defensive expo, and he's just gonna go with a balloon here. Balloon's gonna come in. I'm just gonna go for high Tesla kite here. Gonna go with an ice build, perfect ice build on our end. And my goal here was that the expo is gonna survive. I think it's gonna survive, but not as much HP as I wanted him to have. So we're gonna go in here now with an offensive expo, even as I'm failing on fields. I think it's completely fine, and we're doing a great job over here. Gonna go with a Tesla like that. Don't wanna really play the Tesla too high, because if my Tesla gets killed, he's just gonna be able to play a balloon. So we're gonna do like perfect defense, perfect Tesla placement on our end, and the expo is connecting here. Even he gets like some, even he did like a really great defense, I think it was still fine for us. Gonna go for another expo, and here I just wanted to fireball. I misclicked, I played the Tesla here. Man, so many Tesla mistakes. I just wanted to fireball that, but I think even fireball, we wouldn't have got any damage here. So we get some chip damage in, like every 100 damage, even 50, 20, 10 damage is important with the expo if you get the elixir advantage at the same time or supportive elixir trade out of this scenario. So good situation here. Gonna go for an expo over here. Expo's doing a great job. He's killing the bowler now, and I just want to play passively now. I don't really want to overspend, don't really want to overcommit here. I just want to play passively the game, because I have the advantage. He doesn't have a big spell. That's what I knew here. So this is gonna be really, really spicy, because he has a big push, a bowler and baby dragon and balloon push in rage. Super hard for me to defend. So I need to go like that. I'm just gonna go with an ice build. I was so incredibly lucky that the ice build still jumped on the balloon. You could say it was a perfect defense, but at the same time it was super, super close. So we are still on advantage, but he got like so much damage. So I'm just gonna go the same again, play defensive expo over here, and kinda play the game defensively. So gonna go with this, and I feel like now I'm just gonna get like a great fireball on everything. Really nice fireball here. And he can't really expo, and what I mean with expo, he can't really go with freeze on something, because if he would have frozen it, he would have got any damage and would have been like down 4 elixirs. So I'm gonna do this. I'm even gonna go like with archers at the bridge, I think. Now I'm just gonna fireball that. So my wish was that the archers are gonna survive. Once they survive, we get a ton of chip damage at the right hand side, but he has elixir advantage. Now it's gonna go in really, really hard. Gonna go here with Ice Bird, like left side is everything fine. Gonna go Fire Archers, gonna go with Skeletons to distract the Lumberjack, and we have a solid position right now. I don't really want to go now with offensive Expo, I'm just gonna play passively now. Try to lock cycle him down on the left hand side, and do my job. Oh yeah, pre-placing tested to the right that he can't really pass it, even with like Baby Dragon Balloon Bug. Gonna go with Archers to the left. And I'm gonna log over here just to cycle some triplets in, because you don't need to log anyway most of the time, just because sometimes you need to log to log the barbell away from your expo. But we get some archer chip, gonna play another test, we're gonna take it up against Azorius. One of the, I wouldn't say it's like a really tough matchup, but you have to be really careful, especially I can trouble this time if they get a big push. He got one big push, we were able to defend it, and I'm gonna see you in the next game. Let's go. Okay, Syria at 18-2, and we play against Sergio Ramos. I think most of you guys would know him. It's my teammate from SK as well. So I think he was at the same time 18-0. I was 18 and 2. So I had to win here, and he plays like a really. I thought like it's a really tough matchup for me, but then I knew how to play the matchup, and it wasn't really tough. He plays like AG. He has a bubble as well, and you guys will see. I had a match plan. The match plan worked out, and. If you see the cards, he has RG against the Expo, he has the Bubble, you could think, okay, RG hard counters me. But you guys will see if I play like that, and it's like a, I don't really would say I played like in the nicest way, but I played in the way how you win this matchup. So, you're gonna first go with Archers in the back. I'm just gonna go for Tesla now. Or like, I think I'm gonna go Fireball. Yeah, I'm gonna go with a Tesla first here. And I kind of, like, I was like kind of, unsure what he's playing, because he had the Barbell. Normally you have Glock in the stack, but like after that I already knew, okay bro, it has to be RG cycle with Fisherman Hunter, like a popular deck. Most of the players play Lock, but you can play Barbell instead of the Lock as well. So really important for me is not going like with random offensive expos. It's more about playing defensively, get the chip damage with Lock, Fireball. This is the most important thing, get the chip damage with Lock and Fireball. He's gonna play Hunter next to his tower. We always fireballing that. Gonna play like great skeletons on his fisherman. And we are completely fine here. He has to spend like he has to play into our Tesla, because Tesla is staying there so long under the ground. He can't really play a spell on it. That's why it's so annoying. So we're gonna go for Lock here. We're even gonna go for an Ice Bird just to chip away here. He's gonna go for Barbell, because he knew my plan. He knew like Morten wants to get like just chip damage with Ice Bird, with Fireball, and with Lock. So we're gonna go for Ice Golem over here. We are gonna go with Tesla, really nice Tesla here. And I think now I'm just gonna go for offensive expo, because I knew, I just wanted to find out like, is he really playing RG, like 100% sure. And I had Tesla on the field, so I knew he can't really punish me for that. So great skeletons, gonna go with archers, gonna go for perfect ice spirit here. He's gonna fireball that, but we have just another Tesla here. And I knew he's gonna go from Heal Spirit, so I didn't even decide the skeletons as soon as I could. Like, really important notice for you guys, don't play skeletons too high if you know the opponent has Heal Spirit in his deck. So I played a defensive expo here. Kinda unfortunate time, because at the same time he played RG in the back, so normally I would have pressured RG opposite lane, but I couldn't do it here. So we need to work with that. So I'm gonna fireball that. Fireball Log is killing the fisherman, which is really, really great, and we still got like some value with the bats, and completely fine. No RG hits so far, just fireballs on my tower. So like one fireball on each tower, to be honest. So we're gonna go for Tesla over here. Ice Spirit Log, we're gonna lock that. We're gonna play Skulls on that. Have a perfect archer defense once again, and we are completely, completely fine. Really nice defense so far. We didn't even do one mistake yet, and with Expo 219, it's really hard to play a game completely flawless. Like, most of the time you do one small mistake, but I think we didn't do it yet. So, gonna go for defensive Expo once again. Here I'm gonna go with an Ice Bird. He's just gonna go with bats. And you guys will see, now I feel like I did a mistake. I just should have played Ice Golem. Yes, that's what a good move, Skeletons. And then maybe Archers and him, like Archers or another Tesla. But I decided to go opposite lane. You guys will see, he's like really, really fast here. And he has another RG on the field. And this is not looking that good. He has two RGs, he has bats in the middle to the strike, giving really good bats placement by Sergio here to the strike every troops. We're gonna go Skeletons over here. And this is not looking that good. That's what I thought at least. So we're gonna go from Ice Bird over here to freeze everything up, but we defended it kind of flawlessly. So it wasn't, maybe it was a small mistake, but I don't think it was too bad. So he's now spamming a few fishes, which is kind of annoying, but I think we defended kind of nicely. So, but this looks tough. This looks kind of tough. We're gonna go Skeletons, I think, or we're gonna go first with that. Then he's getting it. Oh, that was like really important for us that the heals we didn't connect and heal the RG up, like back up, and the fisherman as well. Like the fisherman's, like both fishermen's, to be honest. So that was kind of clutch, really important, kind of lucky. Call it however you want to call it. So this is like super looking super good. And I don't really know, I didn't really count, but I think we cycled like 10 logs on this tower. Now we just fireball cycle him, he can't really do anything anymore. I think like, I even think like the bubble was worse, because for sure bubble's better against Expo, but we don't really play Expo offensively, so the log would have been better for him for chip damage, maybe get like some archers down, maybe get like better, hit the skeletons better. So really, I would say a good matchup for us, and I'm gonna see you in the last 19-2 game. Let's go. Okay, so your last game for today's episode, 19-2 against Lavon. Lavon is like one of the easiest matchups, but you guys will see the situation is not good, and we still came back. So even if with a one tower down, normally you say if your opponent is able to get one tower against Expo, you automatically lose the game. Like you guys will see now, this is not the case even like against Lava, or like especially against Lava. And so we're gonna do this, he's gonna spend that. And yeah, I didn't really know what I'm gonna do. So I think now is he gonna Lava. This is like a, is he gonna Lava or a Fanatic? He's gonna Lava. No, normally always, if your opponent's gonna go for Lava, you wanna go Expo same lane, because if you go opposite lane, they're just gonna tower trade you. And same lane, it's like you have the Tesla on the field, you can still normally easily defend it. But at the same time, he went with Lava on the back, we went with Ice going back, two wasted elixir, and I still had to go with Expo on the same, because I knew I can't really go opposite here. So really unfortunate for us, really bad timing luck, and you guys will see this will cost me a lot of damage. So really nice skull and sparse in my opinion. So he's gonna wait here. And then he's gonna go for Miner on a Tesla, really nice Miner by him. I'm gonna go for Archers over here, he's straight up poisoning that, really nice poison by him. But now you guys will see, really unfortunate, Miner surviving with 1 HP, he's chipping away the tower, and the situation is really, really bad. He's gonna zap because he thought like maybe I'm gonna fireball it early, but I just gonna fireball like that. Zero damage, really good fireball by us, but you guys will see, we got like 500 damage at this tower, and we are getting... He got over 1.3k damage at his tower. He's playing really well. Like this guy's like a German Lavon player, like maybe like one of the best German Lavon players for sure. Not the best Lavon player, I would say Karl is the best, but maybe the best Lava minor player in Germany. So I'm gonna go off here. This is like a really important key. I knew I can't defend minor loon. Minor lava poison like in the future, so I'm just went for the tower trade here. Even tower trade is not that great with Expo. And like another important notice is, this time I did it, but sometimes you don't, you shouldn't over defend your Expo. Sometimes your opponent's like spending like 10 elixir on that, don't go with the log, don't go with the firewall for elixir, just play defensively. And then out cycle, most of the time you play Expo the bitch, and opponent's gonna play Giant Prince. Let the Expo die, play a Tesla, play Skeletons, play Archers, play another Expo to get his tower down. That was like a really important fireball, because he still has to spend. He still has to spend poison on dead. So I'm just gonna log here. I'm just gonna ice come here. And like a really important note is what I like learned of like more than I think like 60,000 games in Clash Royale. 90% of the last miners, if you're like in a really tight position, are gonna go in front. So he's gonna go in front of the miner, and he still has to poison dead. And this is like really, really good for us. It was kind of lucky that the baby dragon goes to my Tesla, but even if it would have ran to the tower, he still put a poison on dead. So that was done by me. That was a bad expo. I didn't expect him to have a fair doing back, but that's what I mean. He even overspent to it. I didn't even play a Fireball there. I didn't even want to play Fireball there, but it's a really great matchup. Like, he has no ground answers. Even at 1-1, you always want to play the expo like that, because then your tower's even helping that, and it's really hard for them to build up a push. So we're gonna even go with Tesla at the bridge. Gonna go Skeletons over here. And now we're gonna lock this, and I could have played the Ice Bird earlier, but I didn't do it. I don't really know why I did it. Why I did play it so late. We're gonna go with Expo. This time we're gonna go with Expo like that, because I knew he doesn't really have a great ground answer besides Night Vision. He didn't really have Inferno Dragon, and I knew maybe he's gonna go for Lava Hound there. I thought like he's maybe gonna go for Lava Hound into the middle and would have tanked for Inferno Dragon. So if I would have went Expo high, the tower would have like the lava would have tanked for a tower, and Inferno Dragon would have killed my Expo. So we're gonna do this. Gonna go for Archers here. Gonna go Skeletons. And we get the Expo lock. But right now, like, we still have to defend this. So he's gonna go with Baby Tank. He's gonna go with that. I'm still making pressure with an Ice Girl in front. I think that was a really smart move by me. And we get some chip damage on. So gonna do this. And now we have to wait. Yeah, he's gonna poison it. We're gonna Fireball that. And now we are like even Elixir, but we have like a 700 damage lead. And even at 1-1, he can't really do anything. Like, a really good tip, which I learned from good Expo players, is always play. I didn't really do that much in this matchup, but always play your Tesla like that, exactly like that. Maybe one tile to your Princess Tower, like more, but it's like generally a good move. So we're gonna go for Expo. Even he has like a lava on the field. We're gonna go for another Tesla over here. Gonna go for an Ice Bird. Gonna go Fire Archer to Dragon and Fire Dragon, and then you like he can't really kill the Archers here. So we're just gonna cycle Lock over here. Like, we cycle Ice Golem first. We're gonna cycle Lock, and I don't really want to cycle Fireball yet, because I first want to defend. Fireball is coming in. Really great Fireball bars. Gonna go for Ice Golem here to catch everything up. Gonna go for Lock. Gonna go for Ice Bird. Gonna go for Fireball on the tower soon. And then we're gonna take the dub against easy matchup. We didn't play it perfectly, I think. We had like a really tough start, but we're still able to come back. That means like even against like... Normally if you're at 1-1 against Golem and Giant, it's really hard to win that. But against decks like Lavond, it's not the worst thing to tower trade. Even if it's like you don't really want to tower trade, but if you don't have like another choice, or it's like your only choice to come back, don't be afraid to do it, because at 1-1 you can still win it. He played really well, to be honest. I think it's one of the better lava players in the world for sure. If you guys don't want to miss any videos in the future, don't forget to subscribe for free. Don't forget to put code MOLT in the shop. I'm gonna see you in one of my next videos. Peace out. Goodbye. Thanks for watching.